Good morning, students. Welcome back to your literature class. How's your preparation? Good, yes. So, already in the last class, we have revised the first two chapters from our third unit test syllabus, that is Tidying Up and the story Sheila's Shoes, isn't it? Today, we are going to revise the third chapter from our syllabus, that is Roy's Toys. We are going to have a revision today again. Of the chapter, Roy's Toys. No need to take out either your book or copy. Rather, sit and listen and answer to my question whenever I ask you. Understood? So in the story, Roy's Toys, now first I told you this is a story, so needless to ask, though I know all my children knows that it's a story. Now what happens in the story, Roy's Toys? In this story, there is a small boy whose name is Roy and he had many different toys, right? He had cars, he had puzzle, he had a lorry and drums, different variety. He had a variety of toys with him. And what was the color of his drum? It was yellow in color. Good. Did Roy love to share his things with others? No, he did not like to share his toys. This is the reason when his friends, Mickey, Andy and Ray used to come and ask him to play with them, with his toys, he always used to say, no, I'm going to play hide and seek. I'm going to play only hide and seek and not with my toys. And suddenly, what happened? While the four of them were playing hide and seek, Roy had to search them and he was unable to find them. So he started crying. Yes. And when he started crying, his friends had come to him. And then again they asked if now he could play with them with his toys. But still he said, no, I'm not going to play with my toys. Then what his friends did? His friends said, okay, then we are going. We are going and call us the day when you would like to play with us with your toys. And it goes away. Is it right? Next, what happens? Now Roy understands that his friends are not going to play with him again. He would have no friends now. So he decided to share his toys with his friends. And once he started sharing his toys with his friends, they came to him regularly and they played together. They enjoyed a lot together. Is this the story, is it? Yes. So children, here from this story, what Roy learns, rather not Roy, what do we all learn? What do you learn from this story? Yes, we learn from this story that in order, or if we want to keep friends, if we want to have friends in our life, then we must learn to share our things. We must share whatever, if a small thing, if a small pen, eraser I have, and if my friend asks, give me your eraser. So what should you do? You should definitely share your eraser with him or her. We must always share our things with each other, right? This was the story, Roy's Toys. Coming back to the question answers, what toys does Roy have? This was the first question. So he had different type of toys. You will see in the first page, page 75. And although I had already given you the answers, you may open your copy now. Roy has toy train, a toy lorry, many cars, a big yellow drum, funny puppet, puzzle and many other toys. So these were all the toys that Roy had. What do the other boys want to do? What did the boys want to do? The boys wanted to play with him with his toys. What does Roy want to do? What Roy wants to do? Roy wants to play hide and seek. Why does Roy cry? Roy looks here and there but did not find his friends. So he started crying. So he cries. Right? I hope you are following the copies. Maybe something different I am saying, whatever is given in your copy, but it's from your book. Do the other boys stay and play? No, the other boys goes away. What did Roy learn? Roy learns that if he want friends in his life, or if he wants to be friend with someone, then he must also learn sharing. He must learn to share his things. He has to share his things with his friends. Only then he can be a happy person and he will have many friends in his life. Clear? So this was the story, Roy's Toys. I hope the story is clear to everyone now. Further to this, if you have any doubt, you may call me and get your doubts clear. And apart from this, we have our live class. Your doubts will definitely be cleared if you have any. The last day I was very happy that you people had so many questions to ask. It's good to see that my children are really studying and they have some things to ask. So yes, in the next class also I'll be waiting for your doubts, for your questions. Now, prepare yourself well for the upcoming test. Go through the story very well, read the story, make a reading practice, make a habit of reading daily at least 5 minutes. Give at least 5 minutes to any of the book. I'll not say to read only literature, any book, or you may read a story book if you feel like. Read something, at least 5 lines, 10 lines. Set a daily time for at least 5 minutes to read. It will enhance your reading. Okay, so here we end today's class. Prepare yourself well, learn the question answers, learn the poem tagging our first 2 stanzas along with the name of the poet. Clear? So thank you, children. Stay safe.